So I'm going to show y'all a really quick refrigerator pickle recipe. They're hot, spicy, and sweet, and they're made with hamburger dill chips. Just your basic hamburger dill slices. And you're going to need a jar of that. And I normally make it in 1 gallon pickle jar, usually 1 gallon, and the ingredients and this whole bottle of Tabasco. But when I ran down to the store, they didn't have the gallon and they only had 46 ounces. So I'm going to kind of, you know, adjust it for that. But I'll put what I did today, and I'll put the gallon recipe, because once you taste these pickles, you're going to want to just do it by the gallon. And they take 7 days to like cure, and then after that you have to put them in the refrigerator. But they go really quick, so I always make it by the gallon. So the first thing you're going to want to do, you're going to need the pickles, Tabasco, and sugar. Three ingredients, that's it. And the first thing you're going to want to do is open this jar and drain all the pickle juice out of it. And I'm going to do that in this bowl right here. So I'll do that.
Pickle juice
drained out. No, it's very easy to do. What I do is I wash my hands real good and then hold my hand over it like that. And I use two hands, but then I drain it, just drain it over like that using my hand like a strainer. Or you can use a strainer if you want, but I don't like the dirty excess dishes. So, okay, so you have your pickles drained, and all you're going to do is take, let me see if I can get this with one hand. I'll just show y'all. You want to take 1 cup and start layering it in like that, okay? Wait, I'll make a fill. Okay, guys, I got a cup fill. And what you want to do is just put it in there, put a cup in there. To make the gallon, you just do it in layers. Okay, you kind of shake it down like that. And open your bottle of Tabasco. And start shaking. Okay. Now, when I make a gallon, I use this whole bottle. It's a 2 ounce bottle. So if you don't want them too spicy, you know, put less. If you like spicy though, I definitely try it like that. That's half the bottle, so I like spicy. So what I'm gonna do is put the other 2 cups. You want 3.5 cups of sugar in here, and it looks like it's gonna be hard to fit. But if you can't fit it all at one time, just let it kind of dissolve and come back and add the rest. So what you can do is measure out your 3.5 cups, put it in a bowl, and then put it as, you know, as it dissolves. And I'll show you what I'm talking about.
I got smart and found my canning funnel. So just go ahead and keep adding your sugar and shaking.
Maybe I ought to get it in the frame. Okay. Like that. And then you keep adding. Trust me, it will all fit. But you may have to let it dissolve somewhat. And what I do is add some more of this. But if you want it like the regular ratio, you'll want to add like a third of this 2 ounce bottle to this pickle size jar. The gallon, it would be the whole bottle. So I'm gonna let this sit a little while, and I'll try to figure out about the time, and I'll come back and finish filling it up. Okay, it's been about 20 minutes or so, and you can see how it kind of melted down. It dissolves down. So what I do, I just watch it and add some more. Keep adding it. There, it's to the top again. Take it down some more.
Okay. I have a little bit more to go. I'll just put the top on right here, let it sit a while. Come back later and add the rest. I have it going still here. If you, you know, you could let it sit for an afternoon or whatever, let it. But if you're having trouble with it dissolving, turn it upside down and give it a little lean there so the juice will, see how the juice is reaching all the sugar. Okay. Shake it down. I don't know if I can get it with my hand. Here we go. Okay, be careful because it'll drip out the sugar and stuff. And add the rest. Okay. Just takes an hour or so to get it down in the. Now, what you want to do is clean your top real well, and kind of like canning, you want to clean all that sugar. In fact, usually I go rinse the top, and then I wipe all of this real good. Because what you want to do is seal this and tighten it up. And what you're going to do, let's say today, and what I usually do is put it in a bowl. I didn't get a bowl, let me see. This will be a small bowl, but I do a bigger bowl than this. But let's say you turn it upside down and put it. Okay, that bowl will work. You put it in a bowl for in case it would leak or some chance. And what you do is you tip it over this way for a day. And day two, you put it the other way. And day three, you keep flipping it each day until you get to day seven, and then day seven it should be all done, and then they're ready to eat, and you put them in the refrigerator, and they're very, very good. If you like sweet and spicy, you will love them.